Hello everyone, let's get started with the TCS Elevate Wings 1 PL SQL exam. So let's first see the agenda for this video. At the very first, we will be covering the PL SQL official syllabus, then the exam pattern and the new changes in the exam pattern. After that, the strategies to score the 80 plus and then the questions for practices. PL SQL official syllabus, which is released by the TCS Elevate team which organized this exam. Let's first understand the PL SQL and the SQL. Let's understand the SQL first. SQL stands for Structured Query Language, while the PL SQL stands for Procedural Language Extension to the SQL. It is the extension. It is the language which is developed by the Oracle and it is written on the top of this SQL. It means it uses the concept of the SQL languages. It is just an extension to the existing SQL. In the PL SQL, we run our query in the form of the blocks. It means we run a number of query inside a block. That will be the part of our theory we'll cover later. Talking about the SQL official syllabus, so there is the all basic concepts. You should know the basic concepts regarding the SQL, that is the select statement or the where clause or the any other things which comes under the SQL. This is the syllabus which is released by the TCS Elevate teams. It comprises of the group by, order by, with, aggregate functions like count, average, sum, constraints, indexes, with, and the subquery. You should know all of that. Talking about the PL SQL syllabus, procedure, then the function, packages, cursor, exceptions, views, materialized views, triggers, system table sequences. Let me tell you one thing, that from first to the triggers, it was the official syllabus which was released in 2020. Now I have also included these things, system tables, sequences, and this is etc, which is very important. It means that it will include other topics also, which is not available, which is not mentioned here. Keep in mind that the PL SQL also consists of the topic which is not mentioned here. Moving forward with the exam pattern, as you all know that now the TCS or Elevate teams organize the exam in the TCS Ion Center, which is physically proctored. Means no should avoid any malpractices inside the TCS Ion Centers, otherwise you will be banned for rest of the cycle. The exam comprises of the multiple choice questions, code snippets. Multiple choice question, there may be some question which consists of the multiple options. You have to select the multiple options also. Number of questions will be 40 and the time duration is the 60 minutes. And note one thing, that here you are allowed to move on the first question or the last question or any of the question as you wish. There is no time constraints to the question. Moving on to the new exam pattern. This is not the official released pattern, but it is what the what our students observe from the exam. So earlier there was 50 questions from the SQL, 50 questions from the PL SQL. Now they have changed it to 30% of the SQL and the 70% of the PL SQL. There are more core snippets type of questions, less theory question. What happens earlier? They ask the theory question and it was a little bit easy questions. So now they have changed it to the core snippets. So you should be very well prepared with the core snippets type of question. Now the very most important is the strategy to score the 80 plus marks. Learn all the basic concepts. Study like you have to use this in your work. Don't study like that you are only appearing for the exam and just studying whatever asked in the previous exam. Don't do this. You have to study like that you are using this in your work. So learn one topic and practice question on that. Then only you will be mastered that topic. Focus more on PL SQL. So as I mentioned in the previous slide, that they are asking nearly 70% from the PL SQL. So you should be very well prepared for the PL SQL. And the other most important thing is that practice PL SQL code snippets topic wise. You have to be practice the questions for the code snippets accordingly. Let's see this question. What is the purpose of the above PL SQL code snippets? Let's understand this code first. Create or replace procedure get employee name as. This is the a query or the line which indicates the procedure. Get employee name is the name of the procedure. It will create a procedure or replace the existing procedure. If the procedure exists with this name, it will replace the procedure with this code. Here is the cursor C employees. This C employees means it is the name of the cursor, and the cursor code comprises this statement: select employee name from employees. Employees is the table name, and employee name is the column from that table. This C employees will hold every data from this employees table. Suppose we have the 5 records, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 records. So there will be the 5 employee name also for this one, this one, this one, and this one, this one, this one also. So this C employees will contain all these 5 employee name. Now this begin starts for employee record in C employee loop. It means we are applying the for loop on the cursor data. On this data we are applying the for loop. It will iterate one row, second row, third row, fourth row, fifth row, one by one it will iterate, and it will print the employee name here, then end loop and the end. So it creates a cursor name C employees. Yes, it creates a cursor name C employee, but it's not merely creating this cursor. It retrieves and display all employees name from the employees tables. Yes, it retrieves and display, it retrieves from here this line, it's retrieving the employees name, and with this code it is displaying the employees name. So this is the correct answer. It defines a procedure need get. Yes, it's defined the procedure name with the employee get employee name, but merely it is not doing only this work, it is also doing this whole work. So this is not our answer. It raises an exception when an employee name is found. No, not such thing is happening here. So our correct answer is B. Similarly, going with the second one, what does have the PLSQL code snippets do? Employee ID number equal to 1000. We are assigning the 1000 number to this employee ID variable. Employee name, we are just initializing the employee name variable with the varchar 50. Begin, select employee name into employee name from employees where employee ID equal to employee ID. So it will select this line, will get the select the employee name and assign it to the this employee name variable from the employees table where employee ID matches to this employee ID. This employee ID equal to 1000. So if this matches, then it will assign the values to this employee ID. DBMS output or put line employee name employment, and will also print the same exception where no data found. So this no data found is a type of exception. There is many type of exceptions. One of them is no data found. When there is no data, suppose 1000 ID doesn't exist in the employees table, it means this exception will execute, and when no data found, then DBMS output output line employees not found will be printed. So let's see the option. It retrieves the employee name for the employee ID 1000 from the employees table. Yes, it's retrieving, but merely it's not doing this part. It displays employee not found when an employee with ID 1000 is not found in the employees table. Yes, this is correct. How it displays the employee at the end, it will display the employee not found when an employee with the ID 1000 is not found in the employee table. It raises an exception when the employee ID is not found. No, it will not raise an exception. Instead, we have handled this exception. It updates the name of the employee with ID 1000 to employee not found. No, not a such option is here. So this is our correct option. Moving with the third question, what is the output of the ABAP PLSQL code snippet? Declare counter number equal to 1. We have assigned the 1 to this counter variable, and the type of the counter variable is number. Begin loop DBMS output output line counter value. This is our string, and this is the variable counter. It will print 1. So after the loop, and print this one and the end loop. So it will move here to here only. This is not going to end because we do not have any exit condition for this loop. So it will indefinitely print this one. It displays counter value 1 5 times. No, it displays counter value 1 only once. No, it displays counter value 1 indefinitely. Yeah, it indefinitely print counter value 1. It raises an exception when the counter exceeds. We do not have any such information. So thank you guys, that's it for the video. And if you want to do the practice question, let's join our Telegram group. The link is in the description.